change and spend time with cohorts. I mean, I want to thank you, Richard, for your students here for 6 years. 2024, Katherine, to go to the Lord for your students.
Thank you so much, Brian, and thank you to Kevin and to Annie, who have so eloquently talked about those connections, that cloth and the rebate that we have with the classes of 1984 and 5 and 6, with the family of Katherine Fleming, with the university as a whole, and obviously with all of you, and remembering a remarkable woman and a career. And knowing Madeline as they do, Madeline and your brothers as well, but they are an incredible family. I mean, I can only imagine how much your mother would be looking down for such pride on all of you. And, you know, I'll just say that Katie Fleming is sort of probably even 50 years older than me, and and it resonates a lot with me every time we gather here and talk about Katie. I think about the possibilities and how, I would have looked upon her and thought, wow, what she's doing is just incredible. And would have looked up to her in terms of the way that she leads, the way that she's passionate about the work that she does. And I aspire to do that as well and do the work that I do. And I think a lot about her on a regular basis, not just once a year. This week I've had the pleasure of having a number of amazing women on campus at Coady, partners of ours, and Tsigie is one of those. I just want to acknowledge that others are also in the room and they're so amazing as well, including William Yandy, who is from the Tanzania Gender Network Program in Tanzania. And I have no doubt that there would have been a connection between you and Katherine Fleming had she still been here with us, because the work that you're doing in Tanzania is incredible in terms of ensuring that the lives of women girls are improved, that policies and practices are changed for the better for women and girls, and that grassroots women leaders in particular have their voices heard. We also have in the room today Lucia DeClaire. Lucia is the Executive Director of the Haitian Center, the Center for Haitian Leadership Excellence, CRAE, in Haiti. And again, a force to be reckoned with, a woman leader that I look up to, and who is incredibly passionate about supporting Haitian youth, and particularly Haitian women, young women. Despite all of the challenges that we know are happening in Haiti and continue to happen in Haiti. And so we had this discussion today about that. Tia Bakandar from the Self-Employed Women's Association is also here. Hi, Tia Bakandar. And I recognize that Tia Ben is also, dealing with Indian deadlines. So thank you, Tia Ben. And, the Self-Employed Women's Association, and we had a similar award to this one for South and Southeast Asia, and see time and time again how we would be honoring SEWA. As it is, they are internationally recognized, having 2.9 million members. 2.9 million, getting very close to 3 million members supporting incredible women workers, lifting them up economically, just again, as Kevin was describing for the passion of Haiti. And then finally, Julia Hayagal Salazar. I don't think she's here this evening, but she's the head of the Christian Commission for the Development Bangladesh, CCD. All of those are organizations and those partners have been long-time partners of the Georgia Institute, in some cases like SEWA, the CCD, 50 years. In the case of Tsigie's organization, 27 years. In the case of Coady, which we helped to found in many ways, it's close to 14 years. And CCMP as well, for a long, long time, including in partnership with other community organizations. So this just goes to speak to, how do you choose? How do you choose which amazing woman leader to honor and think about. But I want to focus in on Tsigie in particular, because if you were to ask Indian First staff right now, and I see her in action when I go to Ethiopia, not at the front of the room as I am right now speaking. In fact, she's at the back usually. She's the one going around and making sure everybody has something in their hand, taking something to see a drink, a luna, a coffee. And she's really encouraging for other, her staff, the women that are coming up. She's lifting them up and giving them faith, giving them the opportunity to share her voice, to realize their own agency as women leaders. And that really epitomizes, I think, what we good leadership can be. So Tsigie is the founder and the director of the Organization for Women in Self-Employment, WISE, in Ethiopia. And that's a local non-governmental organization that she founded that operates primarily in Addis Ababa, the capital city, and supports women as they are also trying to lift themselves up economically and to do so in a very Coady way, starting with their assets, what they have, rather than deficits, what they don't. Right now, just to give you an example of why, we are partnering with WISE. We've been partnering with them for some time on two major global care Canada funded programs. And just in this last little while on the current project, more than 6,000 women have been supported. 10,000, between 10 and 14,000 women were supported through the previous project that we partnered with them. The WISE organization has a network of supporting more than 55,000 women, and of course also the men, the household, and I always admire the work that they're doing to ensure male championship amongst it, to really enforce and concretize the importance of women here. Working with 20-plus other NGOs, countless organizations are coming to WISE as an example in Ethiopia. Working with the Women and Gender Bureau, the Women and Gender Children Bureau, and most importantly, that on a day-to-day basis, connecting also with their team and with those women. I can't think of somebody more important here. She's also got the educational credentials to back it all up, including a BBA from Addis Ababa, MBA from the Netherlands. Worked for 20 years at Addis Ababa University, both in administration and in academia, before she joined the development sector. And then she worked in action in Ethiopia for many years. But then she decided to set up WISE. She saw the need. She also learned from her other partner, Self-Employed Women's Association, and took their model of OSCA for 2 years and brought it back to Ethiopia as well. So I'm seeing here in my notes that, you know, it's actually the staff has served more than 100,000 low-income women in support of their efforts to really improve the quality of their lives and the lives of their families. And it's a leading organization in Ethiopia, something that I can attest to when I see it on a daily basis. Since you serve on so many governing boards and committees of different organizations, I know you've received some recognitions and always with such humility, such humbleness in the way that you approach this. But I really look up to you as a sister, as a leader, as a mentor. And I'm very, very pleased that you're offering this support to you this evening on behalf of the Fleming family and their friends in Katherine Fleming's name.
Thank you.